Well, a few people have asked me about Cody Bear. Oh, anyways, here she is. Just about a year old now. And she weighs more than our other two dogs put together. I've been asked quite a few times about how I clean and lubricate my different machines. Now, this is the 860 electronic. I will first take my vacuum with the brush, and I will go underneath the carriage. I will go on the bed. Actually, Cody Bear loves to get vacuumed. That's why she came here. But I will go back and forth across the needles with that. Then I'll take the crevice tool. I'll also try to, and now this is just underneath, but I'll try to get as much as I can, any lint from the air. Or I will take my air compressor and blow it. I haven't done it with the electronic carriage. I would be careful with that. But with my SK-155 and other metal bed machines, I take the air compressor to it. First of all, just, I did not mention before, but you're going to hold the air compressor end away from the carriage, blow it a little bit. Once, because if there's moisture in the can, you don't want to be blowing the moisture in there. So if you just do about 5 seconds before you do the carriage, and here she wants to get vacuumed. Now with the crevice tool, I'll do the same. I'll go along the needle bed. I make sure those latches are open. And then I also go back and forth on the needle slots. And then I go in the back here. I try to get as much possible vacuumed up. Now, when the snow's all melted, I could take this out on my porch with my air compressor. The bed isn't really that bad with the air compressor. The carriage, I would worry about. So now, I do have a couple cans of this Lori Lynn. It's no longer available, sorry. But it is a knit and machine lubricant and cleaner. With my manual bed carriages, I will take and go psst across it. Not with this one. With this one here, I will spray a little bit onto a nice clean. It's almost time to get a new one here. Lint-free rag. And then I will take and wipe all the areas underneath the carriage. Then I will try to curl it up and get on the brass part back here that rides on the back. Then, if it's not too dirty, I take that same rag and I go on the back part of the rail here where the carriage rides and also on the front to clean it. And I see I got a little bit of dirt by doing that. So I find a clean spot. The other thing I will use is this Super Lube. Now, this is also a knit machine lubricant. I put a couple drops on the lint-free rag. Again, I'm going to wipe the underneath of the carriage. You probably can use a Q-tip to get in some of these small spots. If I use a Q-tip, I do it first, then I vacuum and or blow the underside of the carriage. Then I lubricate it, and if you want to use the Q-tip, just make sure none of that cotton stays behind. One of the other things that I will do, now here's one I did the brass railing on the underside of the carriage there. I probably could have used the other side. Is I will take this oil here and very carefully put one little drop on the back rail. One little drop on the front part where the carriage rides. And then I go back and forth. And I can feel it getting easier already just by that. Even though I did oil the underside of the carriage and the brass part, it's still, this little added there will help. Every once in a great while, I will take my needles out to hold in position. I would probably put a rag underneath here, but I'm pretty good about putting a paper towel underneath there, and I just spray so that I'm spraying the latches. Now, these are all new needles, so I don't have to worry about that. For the plastic bed machines, there is a silicone spray. Now, this happens to be from Bond, that I will spray the bed, spray the front of the needle bed there, and then also take the carriage and spray underneath that. For the Bond machines, I'll spray the key plate that I'm going to be using, but I also take this rag and wipe up the excess. You don't want to have too much of this stuff on there. Now, somebody had recently just told me about this LPS-1, that's what you're going to use to, instead of the Lori Lynn lube, and not to use the WD-40. So I went and I looked up a few things, and WD-40, well, WD stands for water displacement. When I look at the LPS-1, it does have displaces moisture on the list. That's what WD-40 was originally made for. But it also lubricates. LPS provides a dry, thin lubricating film. Okay, even if you're using the LPS-1 and you spray your bed, you still, or the underside of your carriage, you still need to wipe up the excess. You don't want to put too much on. The WD-40 cleans. Now, I don't see anything on the LPS-1 for cleaning, but the Lori Lynn does clean. It does say on here about, will clean and lubricate both needle bed and knit and machine carriages. Eliminates buildup on machines and carriages or needle bed. Also, it protects. Okay, so WD-40, next one, it protects metal surfaces from corrosion-resistant ingredients to shield against moisture and other corrosive elements. And I believe the LPS does that as well. I couldn't really get a whole big list on the LPS-1, but WD-40 penetrates, loosens rust to metal bonds. If you get an old machine and the carriage is stuck in place, you could spray the WD-40 on the back side and even the front side, depending on more, I think more the back side's going to be frozen. So I would do that to try to loosen it up, but you're going to have to do some cleaning of that machine as well. And I'm not seeing anything about penetrating on the LPS-1. And then displaces moisture, like I said before. So either one of these is going to be good, as long as you don't overspray, you don't put too much of the LPS-1 or the WD-40 on your carriage or machine. Also, there's somebody I know that has used WD-40 for, I believe, 30 years now on all her machines. Granted, she probably only has a few of them, but she's never had a problem with her machines. Now, as I was reading on about the WD-40, it's formulated with strong lubricating oils and other ingredients and is a terrific product to use for bike maintenance. It does not attract dirt or moisture to metal surfaces. Woo! That's something we need on our machines. But be sure to wipe off any excess WD-40. So yeah, like I mentioned, if you're going to spray it on your bed or on your carriage, you wipe off the excess. Don't let it drip down into the machine, because any lint that goes from the needles underneath the sponge bar or through the needle slots is going to stay in place there. If you watched my video on taking apart the 326 I have, and you saw how dirty it was underneath the needle bed, and some rust that was underneath there, this is what happens when you spray too much and you just let it drip down inside. Of course, I wouldn't take this and spray my bed. I just spray the needle latches if I need it. So, sure, people are going to tell you, don't use WD-40. Don't go by my word. Go look it up online. You're going to find what WD-40 is good for. To me, it was the first thing that came up that you could spray on electronics to displace water, and that's what the LPS-1 was made for. They showed it with a remote control car. And If you have water or moisture in your machine, it's going to cause rust if you don't take care of it. So you want to have some kind of machine oil. There is one out there that's for both sewing machine and knitting machines. I've heard people say don't get that one, but if it says knitting machines, it's good. And I'm sure you're not going to have a problem with it. So it really all depends on your choice of what you want to use.